Hi, this is Kevin Perreault from PEmicro. Since security is such a strong topic focus at the Embedded Online Conference, I thought I would tell you about a security feature that we've recently built into our Cyclone production programmers. Cyclone programmers are used in many production facilities around the world to essentially in-circuit program targets on the manufacturing line. When you want to set up a product for programming, one of the things you'll develop or build is essentially what we call a standalone programming image. Standalone image contains everything that's necessary to program the target. Your binary files, the steps for programming, whether there's fuses or not, CRCs, serial numbers, all that kind of stuff gets built in, compiled into the standalone programming image. So it's essentially a single file that does everything you need. That way, years later, you don't have to worry about settings or finding all the pieces. You have one file that essentially details everything that needs to happen during production. So, what did we add? The piece we added was the ability to create what we call the image key. It's essentially a set of cryptography keys, but it's super easy to create. You create this image key file, and you do two things with it. One is that whenever you go to generate a standalone image, you specify that as the type of cryptography to use. And what happens is when we build this standalone programming image, it essentially is cryptographically secure with that image key. The second thing you can do with the image key is put it into Cyclones, provision a Cyclone with it. And what that means is that once you produce one of these secure programming images, it can only be loaded to one of your Cyclones that has this image key in it. Other Cyclones that don't have the key, it can't load it. They can't understand it. It's not even that it's a restriction on usage. It's that it's cryptographically secure, so the Cyclone can't decode the image. So what it does is it prevents your images, your IP, from being loaded on any Cyclone except for the ones that you own and have provisioned that way. Additionally, inside the cryptographically secure image, we put restrictions. So you can say how many programs are allowed, the date ranges of programming, other restrictions. So it's essentially designed to make sure that your IP resides only on your Cyclone production programmers, and then it's only used according to the restrictions that you put on it. So I'm going to talk a little bit today about the kind of underlying technology, and then I'll give you a quick demonstration so you can really see how easy it is to leverage cryptography with the Cyclone. So let's go over an overview of what it looks like to leverage cryptography in the Cyclone. The first thing that happens, and it's a relatively infrequent thing, is to generate an image key. An image key is actually a collection of different keys that have different functions while encrypting the standalone programming image. This image key file has really two major functions. One is it can be installed into Cyclones. Okay, when installed in a Cyclone, any production programming image which is encrypted with that key can now decrypt those images. So if a Cyclone doesn't have the key, it cannot decrypt one of these secure images. If it does have the key, it can. But both of these things, where you create a key or you install it to Cyclones, is more of an infrequent operation. The operation that's very common that you do quite frequently every time you want to update your firmware that you're programming in the facility is to generate standalone programming images while specifying that image key as one of the inputs. You essentially say, I want to cryptographically secure this image with this image key. And what you'll see is what comes out is an eSAP image, an encrypted standalone programming image. Now that image file can at any time be loaded into Cyclones which have the key. If the Cyclone doesn't have the key, first of all, it'll reject it just because it doesn't have the key. It'll tell you what key it's missing. But second of all, it doesn't even know how to decrypt the image. So what that does is it limits your essentially encrypted SAP images to just the Cyclones that you've provisioned with it. So what is an eSAP image? It may give us some insight into what you can do with an image. First of all, there's an informational header that's all text that just tells you when it was generated, a description that you put in it about what it's designed for, that kind of thing. But it really doesn't have any specific programming data in it. Then it has a section which is cryptographically secure, but secure in such a way that it can be decrypted with the same image key that was used to encrypt the image. And what that means is that you can, as long as you have the image key, you can pull all the settings out of the file that were used to generate it. For instance, what binary files were programmed, what the power settings were, fuse settings, all that kind of thing, so that you can later come back and say, well, how did we do, what were we doing again? We need to regenerate this. Let's take a look at the settings. And so it allows you to look to see how you generated the image in the past. So it has file names and such, but it does not have the binary data behind those files. It's just a super convenient way for you to be able to load this into like the image creation utility and just say, regenerate this image. So if it is a encrypted SAP file, it'll ask you, well, give me the key. And then it goes through the process of allowing you to regenerate the image. Then there's another part of the image, which essentially is secured in such a way that the image key doesn't help you to look at it. So it requires two things. First of all, it requires internal Cyclone specific keys, which are keys that exist only in the Cyclone. So the image can only be decrypted with that part of the image can only be decrypted within the Cyclone. And second of all, it requires your image key to do that as well. So both pieces need to be there. It has to be done within a Cyclone, and that Cyclone has to have your image key. The last part of the standalone programming image is the restrictions, and these are in the cryptographically secure section so that it would be difficult to essentially try and bypass them. And what they are the restrictions on programming, times, dates, counts, all that kind of thing. So let's take a look at what this looks like in actual practice, because I think one of the powerful parts about using the cryptography is you'll see it's super easy to use. Okay, this is the image creation utility that we're looking at, PE. There's actually several different ways you can generate images, but this is one of them, and it's relatively, you know, once you get used to it, it's pretty straightforward. You can see the script file of programming, the speed and power settings. But the part that we're really interested in here is kind of the security settings down this part. So let me just zoom in on that part of the application. Okay, so this application, it programs some kind of binary in the target, and there's no description on it right now. So let me put in a description, okay? I'm going to say this is my widget XYZ version 1.11, 1.22, okay? And for encryption, there's no encryption right now. So I'm going to actually do the pull down. I'm going to say create an encryption key, and I'm going to say, you know, for us, we have a facility in San Diego. So I'm going to say this is my PEmicro San Diego MFG. Okay, my manufacturer there. I'm going to generate an encryption key. And what it asks me to do is I want you to save it to disk. And this is so you can use the exact same key later or drop it to a Cyclone. So I'm going to save it. And it goes through. So I say, okay, done. Good. So now it's chosen that San Diego manufacturing key as my image encryption key for when I encrypt the image. Let me put a couple restrictions on. I'll restrict the date range. I'll say, you know, you can only program to 1,000 units. And I'm going to store just instead of storing it to disk, I'm just going to store it to a local Cyclone I have here. So let's do that. Okay. So built the image. It essentially contacted the Cyclone, my local Cyclone, and it wants to store the image. And it's warning me. Okay, by the way, we need this image you're trying to load has a key, San Diego manufacturing key. It's needed, but you don't have it. Do you want to add it to the Cyclone? Yes. Okay. And what it does is it's done cryptographically. So we actually use some secret keys in each and every Cyclone. They're all unique to essentially transfer your key to the Cyclone. And the reason we do it that way is if your Cyclone is in a remote facility, we want to make sure that there's nobody in the way that can intercept the key, your PE image key. So it's securely transferred to the Cyclone from your PC. If you go to encryption keys, you'll see that it did indeed install the encryption key. So now I'm going to say apply the changes. Actually download the image into the Cyclone, and it does it. So it's there. You'll see what it tells you about the image. It says it's encrypted. Okay, if I right-click on it and I view the image properties, it shows you, oh yeah, it's encrypted, it's ready for execution. It's ready because it has the cryptography key to decrypt it, and the key that it needs is described here. Okay, so if I was to go, there's many ways to program. One of the features we have built into Cyclone is you can remotely see the display. This is if you have a physical person actually using the Cyclone. This is what he would see on the touch screen of the Cyclone itself. And I have a little button here that's just like pressing the start button on the unit. So that'll be super easy. So we'll do that. So we're going to hit the start button. And it goes program, success. Okay, it did it. Yep, programming count is 1. Everything's fine. If I was actually on the Cyclone itself and I went to the menu to choose an image, yep, I can see my programming algorithm right here. I can reselect it or whatever. But let's do something here. Let's mess around with this. Let's go to the encryption keys and let's actually delete the encryption key. Okay? It warns you because you need the encryption key for some of the images that are on it, and it warns you. Your key is missing. If you go to the remote display and you try and try and program it here and see what happens. We launch program, error 25. What is error 25? You don't have the key. So if I wanted to add the key here, I could just, and this is, you know, how you provision a lot of Cyclones, either here in the command line utility or the SDK. You could just add it, say add the key, boom. It's writing the key, cryptographically secure to the Cyclone. Boom, it's there. Now if I want to go again and I want to try and launch the image again, I should see it program again when I try it. So it reloads the image now and boom, serial number increased, the program count increased, it essentially programmed. So that's how it is. You really can see how easy it is to, first of all, generate a key, and second of all, download the key to the Cyclone and just have it transparently work. So anyways, that's kind of what we wanted to show here. We hope you have a great embedded online conference.